being a public servant, done a great job for us. I was in government, Tim Corbett.
Hey, the weather's a lot better than it was this time last year, huh? Raise your hand if you were out in the snow in the street. Right here, this time last year, I kind of came to the hit and run left, giving some of my staff home because it was so dangerous. Now, you still have a full room, and you did last year despite the weather. You have a full room despite the weather again. And this time it's like 60 degrees outside. You all should be out doing your lawns. It's fabulous. To the veterans in the room, I want to add one. And that is to the spouses of all the veterans in the room, and to the parents of the next generation of veterans in the room, like myself. I also want to say thank you for your service, because I think the spouses and the family members sacrifice just as much and have a lot less fun than the actual people that serve, right? Because you're out serving, you're not paying attention to what's going on at home. They're making it us all safe at home so that you can serve us overseas. So let's give them a round of applause. I also want to say that I got a phone call this morning from Lucille, who said she could not make it this morning. She's bringing her husband home from the hospital. So let's say a prayer for him and congratulate to the family. Very, very nice. And my chairman, I can't say thank you enough for all of the times you have brought to me a company that needed help. You have sent to me a family who needed help, who you have shared my cell phone number with so that we as a state can help those people that wouldn't otherwise get help. You're a fabulous chairman, you're a fabulous senator. You stand up for what is right. Thank you for everything you have done to create a great Republican Party in Middlesex. Look at this turnout. It's fabulous. What's going on in Middlesex? And you guys have really begun to show the rest of the state of New Jersey how it is done. And it all starts in a ground game. It all starts in a room like this. Where are all of those teenage Republicans? All you teenage Republicans, stand up. That's the first of the Republican Party in New Jersey. Congratulations. That's a fabulous story. I just promised them that I would drive them around and they could get in my car and we would play Ding Dong Ditch and we did lip docks all the way around Middlesex County here. They love that idea, so thank you very much for joining the Republican team. We need your help. Okay, so you can sit back down. But this is the future of the party. This is what it's all about. It's honoring our past, working for today, and then looking forward to the future. You know, 6 years ago, some of you might forget how hard it really was in New Jersey. 6 years ago, we had a 9.8% unemployment rate. That's 1 out of every 10 people in this room was without a job. That's amazing. 6 years ago, we had 115 tax and fee increases. That's one tax and fee increase every 25 days for the 8 years leading up to the administration that took over in Trenton. Amazing thing. We've had a governor who has vetoed more tax increases than any other governor in history. We have had the largest pension payments of any other governor in history. 6 years ago, we had a governor, you helped elect a governor, who made the hard decisions that had to be made so it would be easier not for us. It's not about us, is it? It's about them. It's about the teenage Republicans. It's about your grandchildren. It's about making the hard decisions so that they have a job after they finish whatever they decide they want to do, a college, a community college, a tech school, so that they come back here and can afford to raise their family here in New Jersey. I don't know about you, but I'm kind of used to New Jersey. I don't want to have to go find another place to live. I don't want to have to fly from Florida up here to meet my family, or for my family to fly down to Florida to meet me. We can continue to make the tough decisions that have to be made in New Jersey if we stick together, if we stick with our ground game. You know, there's a lot of money that's been coming into these elections in the last couple of years, a lot of money that doesn't have a name on it or a place on it. And we will never know exactly where that money's going to go. It's a new game. Took out two of my friends in LD 11. Mary Patty Angelini and Caroline Cassidy. Took out Donna Simon up in LD16. Took out San Fiocchi down in LD1. Independent expenditure, as they call it. But we cannot plan for where that money will hit. But we can plan a ground game that will make sure that no matter where it hits, we're prepared. Because while we may be outspent, I know, because I've knocked on doors in Middlesex County, I've worked with many of you who ran for office in many of the towns that I'm looking at represented by each one of these tables, we will never be outworked. That's what the Republican Party in New Jersey is about. That's what the Republican Party in Middlesex County is about. Working harder because we have the right message. Smaller government, smarter government. Make tough decisions. Not because we want chandeliers and marble floors. Not because we want power. Not because we want to be the power bosses that may lead the legislature today. But because we want a better life for our children. Yeah. So, I congratulate all of you in Middlesex County because you are the people who give the rest of us the courage to keep going, the reason to get up in the morning, the reason to work. You are the people who have kept the faith of the Republican Party. You are the future of our party. I thank you for this, and I tell you this, you give me energy, and you give me faith. And you give me hope. You give all of us hope. So thank you for what you're doing every day. I can't think of another way it should be done. You're creating a new party. You're working really hard on the ground to pick off council people and council seats one by one, town by town, in a very sophisticated way. You continue doing that through November. There is no doubt in my mind we will have not only a Republican president in the office in November 2016, but also more Republicans here in Middlesex County. Congratulations, everyone.